Hi, I'm Rachel, and it's been a while since I've gotten in front of this camera. I think over a week now, and I'm not exactly sure why. I think part of it is that I've been engrossed in reading The Weight of Ink by Rachel Kadish, which I finally finished this morning, and it took me so long to read. It's the only book I've read so far this year. It feels like everyone's racing ahead of me, not that I should care about that. And my head was racing with all sorts of things about this book. I was so engrossed, and I really need to write a review, I believe. And before everything goes out of my head, because I've already moved on to reading the Best American Short Stories of 2018. But I'm here to respond to an even older video idea because, over a month ago now, maybe like a month and a half ago, Jen from Remembered Reads did a book tag about Black Friday, and she talked about not understanding the appeal of acquiring signed books. But meanwhile, acquiring signed books is a big thing of my reading year. I try to get at least 3 or 4 signed books a year, and I told her that in her tag, and although her tag made me feel materialistic about it, but she encouraged me. She suggested that I should do a video where I show off some of my favorite signed books. So that's what I thought I'd do here and now. Here's a quick caveat for me. I don't just acquire random signed books. For me, it's about me personally meeting the author and getting a personalized signed book so that I'm also carrying the memory with me of meeting the author and having an interaction. I also don't necessarily get the appeal of I don't know, just buying a random signed book from a bookstore, although obviously people do love that. They're keepsakes, but for me, I guess really the experience is what appeals to me the most about this whole process. For example, I talked recently in my favorite books of 2018 slash anticipated books of 2019 video about a book that's coming out this Tuesday, in fact, called Echo North by Joanna Ruth Meyer. It's a YA epic fantasy, and we knew each other briefly through a NaNoWriMo Vidler community, and so I was debating and if I should pre-order the book and try to get some of her goodies, and like some of the goodies that she's offering to people who pre-ordered her book are signed book plates. And I'm hoping that she'll personalize it and it won't just be a random signed book plate, although who knows? I guess it depends on how many of them she has to do. But she did do that for me with her debut novel, which is Beneath the Haunting Sea. I actually bought this book from Politics and Prose a couple of days after it was released, but I wasn't like able to meet her in person or go to her release party because she lives in Arizona and I live in DC, and she didn't have the means to do a huge national book tour, although she's been doing a lot, it seems, close to home. But I was happy to support her. I really liked the book, but some months later she had some book plates left, and she put a call on Twitter about who might like a signed one, and I said I would. And so now, even though I, bought this book far away from her and at a different time, I have this inside of the book. And so you can see it is personalized, and she even gave me a post-it note about our NaNoWriMo experience. So that made me really happy. This is, I guess, my most unique, in a way, signed book because the signature and the book are from different times. Next, I think I'll go to my most embarrassing experience, which is actually with the most famous author, I think, of all the signed books I have, and that is Judy Blume, and In the Unlikely Event, which I got a few years ago when it came out, and she did a huge tour and came to Sixth and I Historic Synagogue, which is a cultural center near me in DC, and I was ridiculous, and I didn't think to leave work early or think about the huge crowds that would be arriving before the doors opened. And of course, it's first come, first serve, and I was one of the last people to get a book, and ergo, one of the last people to get it signed by her. So she did sign the book for me after at least an hour or so of signing, I think. It was crazy. I think I was like person 300, and I was just nervous as always about what to say to her, and I'd posted on social media, like, oh, I'm at a Judy Blume event, and a friend of mine said, oh, I love Judy Blume, tell her I say hello. So I get in front of Judy Blume, and, like, she's signing my book, and I blurt out, oh, and my friend said to say hello to you. And she kind of gives me this, like, look, like, is this girl for real? And she said, I say hello back. And I was just so embarrassed. And I mean, now thinking about it, it doesn't seem like a big deal, but maybe it was just the heat of the moment and that expression, like, I am so exhausted and I have to make pithy statements to yet another fan. And so it embarrassed me in the moment. I'm sure she's had worse experiences at least, but anyway, she did sign the book and, you know, personalize it, and, you know, I can't blame her for being only doing this much because, yeah, she signed a whole lot of books that night. I've had so many awkward experiences, I think, with authors where it feels like I don't know what to say, or they don't know what to say, or sometimes it's just like a flurry of, you know, you get in front of them, they sign the book, so there's not much time to say anything. But one of the experiences that really broke the mold of that for me was several years ago at the National Book Festival when I got this short story collection by Elizabeth McCracken signed, because I remember distinctly standing in front of her like a supplicant with a book, like, and she's like, hello, and I'm like, and she said, I'm Elizabeth, and then it just sort of like clicked in my head, oh, I need to be like a decent human being and try to have a conversation here. So maybe that's actually my most embarrassing event, like not treating an author like a person, but we ended up chatting very briefly about the panel she gave earlier and talking about how you didn't have to write every day, which I decided I liked that because I wasn't writing every day, so... Anyway, here's the signature. I've read this book a couple of years ago now, and like so much short story collections, I feel like I don't remember the specific stories that well, but I'm so glad that I write reviews because it brings some things back. I've had this visceral memory of a story in here that takes place in a convenience store. And my review tells me that the story is called The Lost and Found Department of Greater Boston. And it's about a woman who disappears, but it's told through the perspective of her son and then a store manager of like a convenience store, who both remember the night very differently, and I think I remember their altercation the most. Sometimes working in the Jewish world and having an affinity for Jewish books makes for interesting experiences. For example, with The Boston Girl by Anita, Diamant. I get the two events confused about which comes first and which comes second, but if I probe my memory of what I rambled at her in her when she signed this book, I think the first time that I met her was when I was volunteering at an event for a Jewish magazine, Moment magazine, and she was, you know, a guest there, and she came up to me and asked where the bathroom was. And I think I mentioned, maybe not the bathroom bit, but I mentioned seeing her at the Moment event when she signed this book. And she seemed rather cheerful about that. So anyway, here's the signature. Then this one is the most creative signature I have, and so it sort of warms my heart in that way. This book is The Mystics of Mile End by Sigal Samuel, and it's about a family of Kabbalists, and Samuel knows a thing or two about Kabbalah as well, including how to do Kabbalistic charms based on your name and what you want. So she encouraged all of us to ask for something particularly selfish. Like, I tried to get away with asking for world peace, and she said, no, 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 no. So instead I asked if my short story could get published, which then it did. So who knows? But anyway, here's the signature. You can kind of see in the spokes there where she wrote in the Hebrew for my story. And then this Resh Chet and Lamed, that's my Hebrew name, Rachel. This one I'm putting in particularly for Jen, because I believe she said in her video that one of the reasons she would hate to get a book signed is that she wouldn't want to stand in a long line for something. So this was my experience at the last National Book Festival. I went early to the line for Pachinko by Min Jin Lee, and she got out of her talk early, so she came right down to sign our books, and she signed them before her signing line even started. Here's the signature anyway, but the message I want to impart is, if you are forced to get a book signed, Jen, maybe you should go for Min Jin Lee, because you never know, she might sign it before the event even begins. Finally, this would have been my favorite book of this batch up until very recently, or maybe in some ways it still is. This is my old copy of Emperor Mage by Tamora Pierce. You might notice with a lot of these books, I use the book signings as an excuse to buy new books immediately. But several years ago, again, at a national book festival, Tamora Pierce was there, and I had some of her old books from when I was a teenager, and this one is my absolute favorite. It's the 90s cover and everything, and I brought it for her to sign, and she did, and I was so happy. But this final, truly final book I have to show is special for another reason entirely. This one I got signed at the Gaithersburg Book Festival last May, on May 19th. This is Cottonmouths by Kelly J. Ford. I also got books signed for my niece and my nephew. My nephew at the time, I believed to be just a week or two before his due date. But instead, as I was getting this signature, my sister happened to be going into labor. I had my phone off during most of the festival to save the battery, and then I turned it back on immediately after leaving her signing tent, and I was met with a flurry of texts about Jana going to the hospital and Owen being born, and so it's really amazing. I just can't believe I was getting a book signed and feeling confident in the fact that he'd be due in a week or so, but he decided he had to come in early. So that about covers it for me now. I do, in fact, have plans for my next signed book, which will be my first signed book of 2019. I mentioned it in my favorite books 2018, anticipated books 2019 video, that in February I will be going back to Sixth and I Historic Synagogue to listen to a talk by Deborah Lipstadt about her new nonfiction book, Anti-Semitism Here and Now. And so I've already bought my ticket and a pre-order of the book to get signed at the event. Hopefully it'll go better than the Judy Blume debacle. I'll know to get there earlier. I'm not sure I'll be making it to the Gaithersburg Book Festival this year or not. It's usually one of my staples and I love it, but as you might infer from last year's Gaithersburg Book Festival, that weekend will be my nephew's first birthday, so that'll be depending on what festivities will be going on around that. But at least I'll have the National Book Festival in September, and probably other things at the indie bookstores I'll be scouring to see if other authors I like will be visiting, and I'm sure I'll get a book or two signed along the way. And so maybe I'll be back next year to talk about more of these books, or I'll certainly be talking about them in halls and things like that. So yeah, thanks so much for the suggestion, Jen, that I do this, and I will link to your video down below, and thank you all for watching. I'll see you next time.